Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Hope you all are fine. So today we are going to continue our first chapter, that is about internet. Let me tell you about objectives of our lecture. The first one is components of internet. Second one is internet services. And third one is advantages and disadvantages of internet. So first of all, we are going to discuss Microsoft Internet Explorer. Microsoft Internet Explorer is the most popular web browser used for internet. It is a part of MS Windows operating system. If you want to open a Microsoft Internet Explorer, follow the given steps. First one is click the start button, then click all programs, and then you will click on the Internet Explorer. Thereafter, Internet Explorer window appears on your screen. You can open any website through it. Here I am showing the picture of Internet Explorer. Well, let's discuss some components of Internet Explorer. The first one, title bar. Title bar displays the name of current page. It has three buttons: minimize, maximize, and close button. Well, title bar is a small strip that extends across the top of a window. It displays the title of the window. And second one is address bar. Address bar is used to type the address of website in the address box. After typing, press the enter key to open the web page or website. Address bar contains following buttons. First one is refresh button. Sometimes it is likely that the web page is not completely opened or displayed and only few content are visible. Then you may click the refresh button to start reloading the web page. Move to next, stop button. This button is used to stop a web page from being displayed while it is still opening. If you have typed a wrong address, then you must stop it from loading by clicking the stop button. Next one is back button. The back button is used to go to the previously opened web page. Well, here is how it works. Your browser keeps a stack of records showing which pages you have visited the current window session. When you press the back button on your browser, it goes to the last page in that stack. Next one is forward button. The forward button is used to go to the next web page. Recent pages button. When you click on this button, it shows a list of recently opened web pages. This list also contains a history button, which shows the list of web pages which you have visited during a particular number of days. Next one is command bar. Command bar is present in the right hand corner of the page. It contains different buttons such as home button, print button, page button, status bar, scroll bars. So let me tell you about home button. Home button is used to go to the home page of the website. Home page is the first page when you open our website. Print button. Print button is used to take a printout of the page. Pages, if you want to print the current page, you will click on print button. Next one is page button. This button contains a lot of options such as save the page, reload the page, etc. A list of options appears when you click on this button. Next one is status bar. Status bar displays the number of elements to be viewed on a web page and and the progress of the web page being displayed. The last one is scroll bars. Horizontal and vertical scroll bars are used to move the web page horizontally and vertically respectively as required.
To discuss internet service, let me tell you about internet services. Internet services provide a way for data to be transferred from internet servers to your computer. An internet service provider is a company that provides access to the internet. Well, the internet services are, first one is e-learning. E-learning refers to the use of the network and communication technology in teaching and learning. The letter E in e-learning stands for the word electronic. You can use the information from the internet in your work. It increases your knowledge and skills. E-learning has now been used by various companies, organizations and schools to educate and upgrade the abilities of their employees and students. Next service is e-commerce. Electronic commerce is the buying and selling of products or services over the internet. It is a kind of business on the internet. It means you can sell or buy products and services on internet. Okay, next one is newsgroup. A newsgroup is like a notice board on a particular subject. Anyone can write or read a message. People may share their views with each other. Next one is chat rooms. By using internet, you can chat with your friends and relatives in any part of the world. Next one is email. You can send messages and other documents by using email over the internet. It takes very less amount of time to reach the other person. Next one is interactive digital television. Interactive digital television allows user to interact with the broadcaster. You can download the serials, programs and also play games. Next one is advertising. Advertising is a means of communication used to inform the people about a particular item or matter. You may find various links on the website such as for buying any product or service. It helps you to save your time and efforts in procuring such items or facilities. Next one is online games and music. You can play various games over the internet. You can listen to songs, nods and etc. Next one is electronic magazines, electronic papers and electronic books. You can read newspaper, magazines and books online without having to buy them in their paper format. Next one is online banking. People may use the ATM card for withdrawing the cash amount from their accounts. It can also transfer money online from one bank to another bank. Well, students, now we are going to discuss the advantages and disadvantages of internet.
Well, students, we know the internet has made the world a small place. It is useful to us in different ways. It provides us several facilities. So, the first advantages of internet. Well, the first advantage of internet is you can find any type of information on internet with the help of search engine like Google, Yahoo, etc. You can buy or sell goods over the internet. You can also pay bills, read newspapers, and send greetings over the internet. You can easily download songs, movies, and play games on the internet. You can fill online forms,
You can check the train, airline timings and buy the tickets over the internet. You can chat with your friends and relatives online, and you can easily search and read books over the internet.
Well, now we are going to discuss about disadvantages of internet. Virus threat. Virus threat is a big problem for your computer system. When you open corrupt website on computer, there are good chances of virus attacks, and this may give you a lot of trouble and will affect the proper functioning of the computer system. Next one is hacking. Hacking is the process of illegally gaining access to someone else's computer system. The people who do this are called hackers. Despite security measures to prevent illegal access, organizations still have problems with hackers. Third one is loss of personal information. Loss of personal information may be a major drawback of the internet. Fourth one is continuous use of internet is bad for your one mental ability.
Internet also affect our health. Before 100 years ago, there was no any concept of internet and computers, etc. Now every third person uses these things. Because of it, they all the day in the home and face many health problems and disease. Okay, students, so hopefully you understand all the points. Now there is some home task for you. Okay, here are some questions. You will solve these questions on your notebooks. First one is, what is web browser? What is address bar? What is home page? What is use of history button? What is ISP, Internet Service Provider? Give some examples. And what do you mean by e-learning? What are the advantages of internet? And explain the internet services. You can get answers of these questions from this lecture. So that's the end of my lecture. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.